In this chapter, I would like to give you a security overview for the LoRaWAN device. What makes a LoRaWAN device secure? First, you need to ensure your device is using a genuine firmware. By genuine, I mean you are sure this one has not been modified. This is the integrity check. And this one is the one that you created. This is the authenticity check. Those problematics could be addressed by a secure boot. Then you need to have the capability to upgrade the embedded firmware in a secure way. And in a secure way, here you will check the integrity and the authenticity of the new firmware before installing it. But you can also need to ensure about the confidentiality of it. That means this new firmware will be transmitted encrypted. And for sure, to guarantee the security of your system, you need to keep your secret, I would say secret. For this purpose, you will use all the security features possible, hardware or software, to achieve the level of security you targeted. A secure boot should have two main properties. First one, it should be immutable. That means it can't be modified in any manner. Second one, your system should always boot on the secure boot and not on another piece of code. Combination of those properties creates the root of trust of your system. But what does the secure boot code? First, it will check that all the static security of your system has been properly activated. Then it will activate the dynamic securities. Once that's done, it will authenticate the current installed firmware and will launch it, obviously, if the authentication succeeds. Those tasks of authenticity and integrity check will rely on cryptography, so usage of key that you will need to protect. The secure firmware update capability is also needed. This new firmware could be received thanks a local link, UART or USB for example, but it can be also received over the air. This is what we call FUTA, firmware update over the air. In this case, due to the RF bandwidth, the capability to update a portion of the firmware and not the complete firmware is somehow needed. We also call this functionality a partial update. Once the new code is downloaded, the authenticity and the integrity should be checked before installation. Potentially, you can also decrypt if the firmware has been encrypted. Again, all those mechanisms rely on cryptography and some keys that you will need to protect. As previously seen, secure boot and secure firmware update rely on the usage of cryptographic keys. Those keys are static, that means predefined and embedded within the code. The provisioning of those keys are linked with the flash process of the first firmware inside the MCU. Either you have a trusted secure flash environment, or you can also use secure firmware install process if available on your target. We will give you more detail about the SFI later in this presentation. LoRaWAN security also rely on cryptographic keys. Those ones could be updatable. In this case, the key value can be updated in a non-volatile memory storage via a secure procedure using static embedded root key. Once provisioned, those updatable keys cannot be deleted. This functionality is provided by a key management service and the import service. But after the provisioning, you also need to minimize the key value exposure during its usage. This is addressed by KMS, which allows to use key without manipulating its value, but an associated identifier. We will give you more detail about KMS later in this presentation. Here is an example of provision scheme for activation by personalization. On product line, we will rely on the secure firmware install process to flash the first binary, This first binary embedded static keys. Before deploying your LoRaWAN device, you can rely on the KMS key management services to provision application session key and the network session key in a secure way. We will transmit the blob, which is a kind of container, with a two keys value. Those keys value are encrypted. Associated with them, we've got some metadata which allow the KMS to check the integrity and the authenticity of those keys before install them inside the system. Once this provisioning has been done by the KMS, your device is ready to connect to the LoRaWAN network. Thanks for your attention.